It's a simple question. What is a home and what makes a home?
A home is a sacred space that holds dreams, inspires creativity, gives comfort to friends and family, and is just a place where you can be yourself.
So in this season of Metro Home, we will be exploring beautiful spaces that showcase beautiful lives.
I hope that you look forward to joining us on this journey of discovery. Welcome to Metro Home.
There's a certain set of elements we come to expect in a modern home. Lofty ceilings, wide glass panels, a neutral palette, and clean lines.
But life and design are constantly evolving, and in the case of our homes and our lives in general, Filipinos are searching for ways to assert what makes them distinct, what makes us different. Every designer seeks their own point of view, their own signature style. For some, this is a slow evolution, but other designers get to develop their vision and hone it rather early in life. This feature designer has made a splash in the design scene for his fearless and uncompromising projects. He melds bold art and statement spaces. I'm looking forward to picking his brain and experiencing this project with Carlo Calma.
Hi, Steph. Hi. Welcome.
Hi, Carlo. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thank you for coming.
I noticed this awesome piece of art in the front of the townhouse.
It's actually also a mailbox. Actually,
really?
One of my signature pieces in all of the projects I do is I have a sculpture piece outside the house.
I love it. It's super unexpected, and it's just a really interesting way to be greeted. Carlo, tell me about this project.
The concept is actually interlocking boxes. And you know, one of the features of these the house is actually this natural ventilation that we have right now. And we have a small pocket garden with gato colas, which actually are really good for your skin, actually.
And this dining room, tell me about it.
I always have a more minimalism approach because sometimes I want the homeowners to add their personality later on.
Yeah.
But it started off actually with this very beautiful Jinggoy Princessa piece, which has, you know, different textures, and it's minimal in its monochromatic tone. So I kind of played out again with just choosing the chairs with those textures and also the setting right now. So
I love it. You know, I'm a big fan of modern, but I like keeping things warm. And I think that while this is very monochromatic, all of the different textures really make it interesting. And I love how you anchor the room with this very poignant art piece. Shall we explore upstairs?
Okay, sure, yeah.
Carlo, you know, I understand that your family, you know, has really brought modern architecture to the design scene, and you've also studied abroad. What did all of these influences inspire your design practice?
When I start actually on visioning a project, I think of a concept word, you know, a one word, like
one
a manifesto. That will be actually the concept of the house. And then I use that to my advantage actually to just be more edited and just really then explore that word, because I think it's that language that I think that are the abstraction that becomes spaces that are interesting for me, you know.
I love the contrast between the very modern cutting edge technology that you use, but still hone and highlight a lot of the traditional and more natural elements. Tell me about this room.
Well, this room has a lot of personality.
Yes.
So much color. But
look,
you know, I think
this.
it's really something we can aspire to, you know, have a space wherein you have a blank canvas of a white box But then, you see a piece of art that actually draws you in, and then maybe these would be the inspiration of your palette.
Yeah, I like the idea of developing the room, you know, around a piece that really speaks to you. So like in this case, I can imagine like this is such a statement. Then you sort of build all the accessories and the color palette around that. And you exercise this restraint very well amidst the chaos. Right? No, so let's explore the rooms. This is unexpected, you know, to have a little dining table here, but it works very well.
I believe nowadays the modern living, you know, is that you don't need to define the space. Let's say the dining area could be like a space of a nook, or you know, like your rooms could be an office.
So we're heading to the bedroom, and I love how you put these windows in unexpected spaces, no? Mm-hmm. Did you really think about including that in the design?
Yes, we wanted to put an atrium to have, of course, natural sunlight, ventilation, the green, and also to separate the two homes, you know, so, you know, you still have a sense of kind of like community, you know?
When you think of townhouse, you know, you think of tight spaces, but with the windows, that really gives it some breathing room. So tell me about this playful room.
Yeah, these two pieces are like just my fun, whimsy art pieces I had previously. Also, I think for me, like spaces like this bedroom, the lighting design, I normally just frame the room just so that to create a kind of more ambient room.
So your standard, you would say, is for every bedroom, or actually, would that be for any space that you do cove lighting?
So for me, I use the cove lighting idea as a kind of a way to kind of choreograph the person living or the guests, that sometimes it will spill to the hallway, or it the light for me is also a way to like choreograph the space. Yeah,
I think you also have to really think about the function of the spaces,
definitely.
And this just really drives mood, right?
Yes, definitely.
So there's a third level.
Yes, there is.
Okay, let's see that.
So here's the master's bedroom.
Okay. Oh, I love the light.
Yes, again the cove lighting to just create the mood.
And then you do have natural light too, because this is facing the front. Please share with us what is probably the most rewarding feedback you've heard about your work.
I became an architect because I'm happy to see clients curate their lifestyle. But what I think also important is that I don't impose my lifestyle to them. You create spaces that are livable, experiential, and also you try to break the boundaries of what is modern living now, creating what is the new identity of Philippine architecture. But I believe also in the authenticity of designers to have their own kind of style.
Thank you, Carlo, for touring me around this project. It's such a pleasure.
Thank you, Steph. Thank you for coming.
You know, meeting an audacious creative like Carlo Calma can be quite liberating. I'm sure that you're an inspiration to so many people, and people who want to take the great leap into a certain aesthetic design.
When designing a contemporary home, there's got to be key elements. And this mix of materials must project a cool statement, both literally and figuratively. Looking at this home, and we see the facade, it's going to be a quintessentially contemporary home. One key element that I see that's prominently used here in this contemporary home is the use of tiles. And I think we might associate tiles with perhaps old world architecture. But fast forward, here we are witnessing the art of Spanish tile giant Porcelanosa. And in contemporary design, the use and the mix of this tile is a tool that will show you how it can actually work with contemporary living. Moving forward in this home, we see a lot of touches of design, like this beautiful console table that's made by Vito Selma. And this is one of my favorite chairs, the sunset chair by Capellini. I love how everything here is mixed. You know, you have different heights and different proportions, lengths. And this is a good touch to put in a living room that provides you extra seating. Ottomans or little stools, you know, which give your guests the versatility to actually move them around so quiet or cool conversations can take place. Stepping out into the porch, we notice there's a lot of wonderful airy furniture. This is by Kenneth Cobonpue. And what I notice most here and I like and appreciate is the use of the seamless tile that goes all the way to the pool. I like how this blue pool connects to the gray tile. And I like the use also of this patterned tile here on the wall behind me. It's very contemporary, and the way it's juxtaposed with all this natural wood and metal is totally cool. This is a good example of how a well-planned kitchen should be. You have everything within access of each other. What's beautiful is you have this central island, so it's easy to prepare meals and it doubles up as a nook, as you can see with the bar stools. And speaking of an open-plan space, that's easy access to all key spaces of the house. And I'll show you a very good interior design technique which leads the kitchen into the dining room. So here I am in the dining room, and this is what I meant about the most clever design statement that I discovered in this home. Apart from the use of tiles, of course. Here we have a very nicely put together wall out of graphic coat. And if you look at it plain sight, you won't really notice that this is a magical door. What I especially love about this dining room is the use of mixed pieces. This is also interesting how we have these three globe-like lighting fixtures on top of the dining table. The grouping actually makes it very cohesive with the whole dining table setup. We have this really comfortable banquette that takes the expanse of one side, and on the cabeceras, you have two gracious looking wing chairs, and in front of me, a set of parchment chairs by Kenneth Cobonpue. This is a good example of how casual entertaining can elevate into a formal setting by just, you know, pumping up with the materials that you use on your table. This is a good example of material mix. So we have wood, we have glass, we have the tile here that looks like sandstone, and we have metal elements that all work together that show you how contemporary design is actually forward with the use of materials. So let's go up so we can tour more of the home. So here in the master bedroom, we still have the same calming palette that we can see around the house. I love how they incorporated this kind of soft wash wallpaper. It goes well with the braid here that we see of the headboard. I love how all the colors coordinate in this home. And, you know, it makes one space connect to the other. So as we lead in to the master bathroom, we can see the same use of gray, whites, and soft tones. So I like how everything is so well thought of in this house with regards to partitions. We have this glass sliding door here, which separates the bathroom from the walk-in closet. And again, the use of tile. We have this gray, sort of, you know, slate-like looking tile. And we move up to the wall. I love how this geometric patterned wall translates to everything in the bathroom. Wow, this room is so youthful compared to all the other areas in this home. When you talk about contemporary living, it's actually a mix of many design styles. And here we have a bit of the traditional and the old world with a pair of chandeliers that flank the bed. And then we have these quirky little diamond-like drawer pulls. So this room is very youthful and it's actually chic as well. We're here at the Porcelanosa showroom in BGC. It's an exciting place where you'll find a range of tiles, natural stone, and other products that you can use for your home. I'm with Jose Maria of Porcelanosa, and I'd like to ask him a few questions for all of you to know the brand a little more. Jose Maria, thank you for joining us in Metro Home.
Thanks to you. The company, well, my grandfather and with his partners started the company in 1971. And the DNA from its first beginning was to create something that was more than tiles. What we want to offer to people is a lifestyle.
Now you've developed your line into kitchens and flooring, meaning with other materials, or do you still work with tile?
We still work with tiles. I mean, it's part of our DNA. It's a part of our, the way we are, the way we grew as a community. So tiles are in our DNA, but obviously now we are reaching other kind of materials.
We're here with Mr. Rally Martinez, the chairman of Porcelanosa Philippines. Hi, Rally. Thank you for joining us at Metro Home.
Thank you for having me, Anton.
Rally, I'd like to ask you a question. What sparked the interest in Porcelanosa, and why did you choose to bring it here to the Philippines?
I was really looking for a reliable, reputable supplier for building materials. So I came upon Porcelanosa of Spain. So when I went to Spain and visited Porcelanosa Grupo in Castellón, Spain, I realized that this was the company that I was looking for. They had a wide range of products that I could purchase and include in my projects. So when one of the owners, Mr. Sylvester Segara, decided to create and organize a first international Porcelanosa affiliate in the Philippines, and he asked me, would I want to be his partner? I gladly said yes. I knew that the Philippines was ready for a one-stop shop of building materials that not only provided an extensive range of products, but rather competitive pricing.
So Rally, tell me, how has the market received the brand? Like, I know, of course, when you think of tiles, then you go to the bathroom, and then okay, maybe the kitchen, but it's a big market, right?
Initially, when we started, the Philippine market thought it was such a premium brand that they felt a little bit intimidated. But, you know, as they say, you build it and they will come. Testament to our success is really success of our Cebu branch showroom, which was only opened 2 years ago, but is now one of the best performing showrooms also worldwide because of its 100% growth every year, year on year.
So Rally, we're looking forward to seeing the full product line of Porcelanosa. So I'm gonna tour your showroom.
Yes, thank you very much, Anton. I'm sure you will be surprised at how vast a range of products that we have right now in our Porcelanosa showroom. And this is actually only 5% of all the products that Porcelanosa has in its main showroom in Spain.
This is the bitter kitchen?
Yeah, this is the bitter, and it's for to provide all the tools that you need during the preparation of the food and cleaning all the food, and even could be also used in the living room for the mini bar with the drinks and the glasses. And yeah.
So Miguel, you can actually customize everything like in the sections of this whole cabinet?
Correct. You can really customize size and also finishings, colors, and all the equipment that is inside.
I realize that everything is outfitted so well. So it's like, if you're so OC and organized, this is your dream unit.
Yes, correct. You can really adapt depending on necessities. So for cutting, preparation, also storage, if you push, and big capacity also for the species.
So then you have different things here, different components, yes, which will actually suit every need.
Yeah.
Even here.
Correct. For all the cups, glasses, you know, everything depending if you want to have bottles.
Like storage.
Mm-hmm. You can really customize depending of every compartment, so you can really choose your equipment. So also finishes and colors in wood or in lacquer. So.
This is nice and sleek looking. It looks like a capsule.
Yeah, it's really special, this basin.
It's made of a special material?
Yeah, it's a creon, it's our solid surface from Porcelanosa, and we inject this material in a mold. So we can do different shapes and different sizes also.
I find this very interesting. Is this tile?
Yes, it's ceramic tile, but looks like wood. Also the floor is porcelain tile, but looks like wood, and the people, they don't know really if it's original wood or is imitation. So the advantage is all the cleaning and the maintenance that give you the porcelain tile, so you don't should be worried about all the water and all these issues.
And I like how the warmth of the wood tile goes very well with the sleekness of this design.
Yeah, also you can choose different colors, different sizes, so the range is wide about the options in the porcelain tiles look like wood.
Okay. Oh, Michael, this is really cool.
Yes,
this is a collaboration, I understand, with Dame Zaha Hadid.
Yes, this is a collection Vitae, designed by Zaha Hadid. And we are so proud because the design is fantastic.
Yes, this is like my new dream shower system.
Yeah,
I love the sleekness, cutting edge design. It's wonderful.
Yes, it's really nice, the shape and, you know, all the design. Yeah, it's really...
Yes, you can really tell with the movement of the design that the fluidity is very Zaha Hadid. So I like the design of this. It's so sleek, and I like how this actually just like conveniently slips in, so you have it in all one whole unit.
Yeah, it's following like the drops, the shape of the drops of the water. So really, with the
would you know how many spouts?
I think it's 100.
100.
Yeah, more.
Okay, and then the sink system, the curve and the design is fantastic. So this mirror, I'm sure the lighting system is built in.
Yeah, right? It's inside and also is following the shape of the basin and also
everything.
This is represented the drops of the water, also the concept with the shower.
Yeah.
So everything is a conjunct.
So this I also find interesting, Miguel. Tell me about this.
Yeah, this is very slate. This is natural stone. The particularity is the big size of this material is 2.4 meters, but also is really soft because it's just 2 mm thickness. So you can use in outdoor and indoor, and also you can adjust in the shapes as a column, for example, because you can mold in a curved shape.
Yeah, so because of its thinness, it can actually follow a contour.
Correct. Has a fiberglass on the back that give you this this particularity that you can really bend the shape.
thank you for joining us. We hope you enjoyed your tour at the Porcelanosa showroom.
Modern living nowadays has a lot more fluidity. The spaces are not as strict, defined, and formal. You just have to be a little bit more creative, think outside the box, and not necessarily follow the floor plan given to you. Here are some tips for modern living. Lighting drives the mood, so you have to think of the function of the spaces. For example, you can make the kids' room bright and the master's a little darker. Space planning. If you walk through a contemporary home, you will realize that in its architecture, there's a lot of open spaces. One space leading to another open plan, and that's what really makes a comfortable contemporary home. Mix and match. Don't be afraid to combine elements. You can elevate a simple setting by utilizing a good material mix. Accent pieces. Choose furniture with clean lines, streamlined silhouettes, or character pieces that are structural, quirky, and strong.
So if some viewers still find that a modern home is a bit daunting to take on, I hope that in this episode they will realize that they can find an unexpected bliss with a modern home.
They don't also need to stick to a certain theme. Like I said, think a little bit out of the box. Modern doesn't have to fit into one box. I've always felt that adding contemporary pieces to a traditional home or an antique piece to a modern home can create a fun energy in any space. We encourage our viewers to dare to be experimental in their homes, and we hope you enjoyed this episode.